Coulter is, of course, the best-selling author. She's had a lot of huge bestsellers. Her new book is coming out now. It's called Resistance is Futile. You should get this book. You can go to Amazon right now and pre-order it, or you just go to AnnCoulter.com. Ann Coulter, how you doing?
Fantastic. How are you, Mark Simone?
Very good. Resistance is Futile. That's a great title. And
thank you.
One good example is CNN, MSNBC, all the media that said, we'll just attack him 24-7 and claim everything he's doing is wrong, and that way everything will change. But he keeps going up in the polls, so why don't they learn that, why don't they say, you know what, our tactics aren't working, let's try something else.
I know. That thought has never occurred to anyone in the media, and you have it exactly right. This is like, my book is like slander, too. It really is about the media, and that's exactly right. I think it's because they're like comedians. Why bother working up a sweat doing a good job at what we do when all we have to do is attack Trump and we are guaranteed 2 million viewers?
But
it's a lazy thing to do. I mean, even if on their own terms, if they cared about the country, they'd attack him for their things to attack the president for, not what they're doing. And it is getting crazier and crazier.
So, like this LeBron James thing with this Don Lemon.
Well, I mean, there I'm going to disagree with you.
Well, I'm just saying, if you call the guy all kinds of names, if you attack him for an hour, he's probably going to respond. And what's the first response? That you're dumb.
Well,
or a moron.
Well, in the case of our president, yes, I will admit you are right about that. I will totally defend the president on the racism charge on that. As you may have seen yesterday, I tweeted a partial list of other people he has said have a low IQ.
Oh.
And I listed about a dozen, you know, Mika Brzezinski, Arianna Huffington, David Brooks, on and on and on. But okay, leave the completely idiotic thing aside. It's one thing, and I loved your tweet saying that it was unfair and named a bunch of other people in the media who are way dumber than Don Lemon. That was very good. No, I will not say any. I will not defend any of the other people Trump has accused of having a low IQ. Many of them either do have low IQs or they sure act like they have low IQs. But LeBron, oh, he is famously smart. And people have looked at it because, you know, he didn't go to college. Well, why? Because he was busy making $80 million in professional basketball and not risking an injury. He is, and not only is he famously smart, but we have some races in Ohio. You know, do not tangle with sports fans. You do not want to insult the beloved star, the beloved son of Ohio right before an election. No, that was low IQ. And that's why, which brings me to my next point, which I think I've promoted on your program before. And thank you. I guess you have a lot of influence with the president, because days later he said he was going to do it. And that is what he needs to do is clear his schedule all of September and October, do nothing but rallies. But he ought to study his own speeches. I mean, his best speeches, for example, when he introduced Brett Kavanaugh, he's completely right. He can be presidential when he wants to be presidential. That was beautiful. I mean, he can throw in a few jokes and, you know, chit chat with the crowd and everything. Look at the Kavanaugh introduction. It was. Maybe the best I've ever seen him. The immigration speech he gave in Arizona when he had said something stupid about going soft on immigration during the campaign. Absolutely beautiful. His State of the Union address, beautiful. He has to do rallies like that. He can't go into people's hometowns and insult the local star. That will backfire.
All right, but if a guy calls you all kinds of names and someone asks you about it, that's a normal response. He's an idiot.
Yes. Yes, that was clearly what he was doing. Yes.
Well, that's all right.
Well, I think we should. I saw that fortunately Melania came out and said something about LeBron being smart, which is, so they must have realized, oh, crap, you just called a really smart guy dumb.
Well, wait, but that's you women. This is how you women are. If a guy says, look at that idiot over there, any woman goes, don't talk like that or don't be so judgmental. That's just the way women are. They're nicer about everything.
Mark, I'd like to, nice to meet you. I'm Ann Coulter.
Well, I'm talking about a normal person. that's why people like you. You're like honest.
I am, including when the president makes a mistake, and that was a mistake. But
yeah, wait a minute. Who are you to say he shouldn't be insulting people? You would have said the same thing.
No, not right before a midterm election with races up in Ohio. Though, yes, you are right in your description of what he was doing. But
all right.
What, and by the way, what is he doing watching Don Lemon for anyway?
The same reason we watch it. It's hysterical. It's funny to watch. I love watching that MSNBC where they get all bent out of shape about nothing.
You see, you are not as obsessive a hate watcher as Ann is.
Yeah.
That is on CNN, Mark. That's the lesser crazy station.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
I can give you the entire schedule. I set my day by what time various shows on MSNBC are on.
It's actually enjoyable to put it on and see Rachel Maddow and Chris Cuomo to see how mad these people are. It makes me feel good. Well, you know he's doing something right if they're really annoyed. And they look, it looks not just like hatred, but like fear. They're really afraid he's going to get reelected.
I think it isn't only because they never encounter anyone who knows anyone who voted for Trump.
Yeah. That's true. They never actually visit the country. They've never, right from Manhattan to the Hamptons and back. They never actually visit anybody in America.
Oh, except for the Trump rallies, another great reason for the Trump rallies, so people can cheerfully chant CNN sucks, which brings us to our next topic.
Yes, Jim Acosta.
And that is this hysteria over, we're being threatened, we're being threatened. Well, you probably saw the videos. This is when I want to strangle the people on my side, just, as a side note, because I will thank whatever it was, I think it was PJ Media for putting up, I mean, I didn't particularly take this journalist or being threatened seriously to begin with, as you know from reading my book, Demonic, about mobs and groupthink. The violence always comes from the left. It never comes from the right. So, stop being little girls in pink party dresses. No right-winger is going to attack you. Michael Moore could walk, Rachel Maddow could walk freely any place in America. Can I? Oh, no. Come on, walk with me through New York City sometime. Walk with a MAGA hat on. But in any event, they found these, PJTV found these videos of really horrible violence against Fox News reporters. That poor, remember Griff Jenkins? I don't think he's on Fox anymore. But anyway, he was so adorable and so great, and he's just out reporting on, I guess it was at the Democratic National Convention, and it is nothing like the cheerful Trump supporters chanting CNN sucks. These are angry people, women with masks on their faces. It was like a precursor to Antifa. They're actually driving the Fox reporters out. Obviously, it's not Fox sucks. It's F Fox, giving the finger to the camera. Really, really violent and angry people. Same thing at some, I think it was the protest over Eric Garner in New York. I mean, it really looked, dangerous and frightening. Just put them up and compare the two. But no, the conservative, well, you can just watch the videos and that's the ending, but the conservative writing about it, the accompanying commentary was, it's wrong when both sides do.
But you're right. It usually comes from the other side. The left always attacks the conservatives. You've never seen anybody pushed and shoved because they had a Hillary button on.
Every presidential assassination, at least that was based on, in some sense, on politics and not just some nut who thought, the president was was the king of England and owed him money. Every single one was by a leftist.
Well, if you want to read a great book, it's Ann Coulter's new book. It's about to be released. It's called Resistance is Futile. Now, you can order it right now on Amazon. When does it come out? Like in a week or so?
In a couple of weeks, August 21st. I'm so excited. I can't wait to be talking about it.
But pre-order it because you always, I don't know why, but you always get it days before it comes out. Amazon always does that. So just order Ann Coulter's book, Resistance is Futile.
Also, the first edition is going to be a collector's item because of the huge, massive error on page 170.
Yeah, there's a mistake in the book. It will not be corrected till the second printing, so get the first edition. And you can go to AnnCoulter.com. You can get her column, follow her on Twitter. And Ann Coulter, thanks for being with us.
Good to talk to you, Mark Simone. Bye-bye.
Take care.